All right, if you're using Go High Level and trying to scale, you need to watch this. Eric, one of the guys in our community, has built a 30K per month high level agency and has over 200 sub accounts. And he did this without a huge team or spending a ton of money on paid ads. In this video, he's gonna break down exactly how he did this. And at the end of this video, I have a special surprise for you. Let's jump right in. What's up, everybody? I am here with one of my OG students, Eric Smith. He is absolutely crushing in the agency game and is here to share some of his secret strategies and his wins. Eric, thank you so much for being here, man.
Hey, pleasure's mine. Pleasure's mine. Thank you so much for inviting me.
So the first thing I want to start off with is, you know, the big question everyone wants to know, where are you at revenue-wise and how many clients you have? And then we'll kind of reverse engineer from here.
Yeah, so we've got about 200 or so sub accounts. And I remember when I was first trying to get to 100, and it happens pretty quick. Agency wise, you know, we're hitting 30 plus a month, and
30,000 a month.
And again, I remember just at the beginning, just wanting to get to 10 grand, you know, that's always kind of the goal, is to get to 10 grand. And so we're really wanting to try to push that further this year.
I love it. Yeah. Isn't it funny how that works? You start off and you're like, man, 10K, so much. So when you get to 10K, you're like, that's nothing. I need to get to 20. You get to 20, you're like, got to be at 30.
And then it's got
to
be 30. Yeah. And you just keep pushing. Yeah, absolutely.
I love it. So let's go into a bit of the strategy, you know, where you started. Just give us a little rundown of, you know, back in the day when you first got started. I know we talked about COVID and how it affected
you
know, where you're building. So just a little backstory. Because you kind of had those highs and lows, you know, and you rebuilt very well.
Absolutely. And so, you know, 2020, we were the agency itself, and this is pre working with GHL. We were at like 60, 70 grand a month. And when COVID hit, employees went everywhere, back home, you know, and we had to do a lot of remote work. And I was like, I got to do something. I have to revamp. Clients were falling off. I think we wound up being around 10 grand a month, you know, from 60, 70 grand. And so it really hurt us. We started losing employees. And I said, I got to do something. I stumbled across a YouTube video about GHL. And I said, I got to implement this. I have to figure out a way to streamline everything and rebuild without the high overhead of an agency. And I think that's part of what I learned too, is how to run an agency really efficient, less overhead, leveraging more software, AI, of course, now. But yeah, so we almost lost the business. And then GHL was significant in rebuilding that because, you know, working with you and working with other coaches with different aspects of it, one of the things they said that it helped significantly was churn, you know, and when people offboard, they don't ever offboard 100% like they would if a traditional agency.
Yes.
They're going to keep different aspects of the tools, which it just continues to build, right? Almost like, I guess, mailbox money. They're using the software. You're getting paid for some type of hosting or reputation management or something like that. They never completely go away. So that's been very helpful.
Yeah, that's what you said there is key, Eric. Having your churn go down is one of the biggest things. And I noticed that same thing when I fully went into high level, is that if you can give them, you know, a proper snapshot or something like that that has, let's say, the payment processors, reputation management, automations, kind of a bunch of stuff.
Yeah.
It's hard for them to leave. Like they can pull out from maybe your ads or SEO, but like you'll always be getting some sort of monthly money if you do it right. So that is, yeah, couldn't have said it better. That's a huge part.
A huge part. Because your base just keeps increasing, right? Even if it's small amounts, it's like that Netflix idea, you know, you're always, even if it's $50, that's $50 you continue to add every month, you know, so helped tremendously with churn. Plus, you know, they talk about software being sticky, right? Once they're in there and they're, let's say they're just using the email blast portion of it, you know, they love it. They keep using it. They keep paying for that. And then they're always there later. They may call you up and say, hey, can you help me with this? They still got an account. You launch it, you know, you charge them for whatever that extra service is. Like we met because we started talking about Google Business Profiles.
Yep.
And I jumped in then with you. I was just at a meeting last couple days ago where they're already a retainer client. And so I'm like, are you managing your Google Business Profile? And they're like, no. What do you mean? They didn't even know that you need to do that. And so I was able to add that to their monthly retainer. And of course, leveraging GHL to to handle all that.
Yeah, that's just such a big thing. Because if you can, it's almost like you can upsell your client base risk-free. Because if you upsell them and then they go, well, hey, this didn't, the ads didn't work, the SEO didn't work, just fall back on the software retainer. So it's like, it just keeps going back. No, I love that. So one of the other things I really wanted to discuss on is AI, because it's huge. In my Sean Clark interview, he was saying, you know, selling AI chatbots, AI agents to service-based businesses is the next big thing. I want to know what your opinion on that is, because I think that's big for all agencies and how you see at your agency kind of implementing AI. And that's kind of the next big thing and what you're really doing with that.
Yeah, so I would say 9 out of the 10 conversations I'm having now, just as an agency at the table, is how is AI affecting the business? How can we utilize AI? Well, in GHL, there's so many ways to leverage AI. Like you said, the chat bot. We teach tell them how we can train that bot to answer the questions specifically about their business, how it would save them time as far as a receptionist or someone who answers a phone or whatever. A lot of these questions can be answered with AI prior to them, eventually reaching out to them for whatever service it is. So, of course, you do get the conversation of, well, some people don't like to deal with bots and stuff like that. True. But there's ways to make the bot feel more human, and things like that. So, I think you're absolutely right. Sean's absolutely right. AI and leveraging that is the next big thing. So most of the conversations lead to that. And we have an offering, you have an offering for that, and you can answer those questions, and you have different aspects of GHL that handle that, and you can show them. I mean, they're sold. Sold them.
No, yeah, AI is changing the game forever. It's also, it's a completely blue ocean. It's unsaturated. Very few businesses have AI solutions. So if you can get in there, I mean, you're getting in at the perfect time. And actually, speaking of perfect time, let's kind of talk about your future. You're at 30K a month, you're, you know, 200 plus sub accounts. Where do you see yourself, you know, Eric Smith's agency, let's say December of this year? Well, where do you see? You think you're gonna go up to 40, 50? Where do you see your goal?
Yeah, I mean, conservatively, I think you can add another 10,000 to the bottom line, pretty easy. Because once you get past that first 10, then it's easy to keep replicating that, So it's just a matter of saying, okay, we want to add another 10 grand. What? And there's so it's just it's there's so many available opportunities inside of GHL to do that. Like if we could build something around just reputation management and go out and sell that for 500, $1,000, or you got 10 more clients, that's your 10 grand, Because there's so many different aspects to it, I think that's easy to do. So I conservatively would say at least another 10 grand, right? But I've seen people double. 30 grand, 60 grand, 90 grand, just depends on your team and what you're trying to accomplish.
100%. All right, last question, Eric. What advice would you give to an agency first starting out? Not an advanced agency, but say someone comes in, you know, they wanna have the 10K plus months, they wanna live the agency life, you know, they wanna do this. What do you say to them? Is there a piece of advice? Is there a strategy? What would you give them? Because there's a lot of people.
So the strategy is to just start, right? You only need to just get one client. I know when I started it, I knew I was the service I was providing was probably worth $1,000, $2,000, but I'd only charge $250 because you got to get those case studies. So go help someone. I would even recommend take your first client for free because the value of what you're going to do for them and be able to use them as a case study. I know you could take the next customer, you can say, yeah, we work with so and so, and this is what we've done for them, right? That the value of that's going to be 10 times, even if you did the first one for free, right? And then start low, start $250, 300, something that, it's kind of the same model as GHL. It's almost like a, electric bill. People don't worry about it. $200, $300. Get going with that, and then start increasing the price at the next sale. Go to 500 a month, go to 1,000 a month. And just start, like the cliche of do it, just go for it. Take the first step is really it. Find a coach, find somebody that with a low or even some of the free offerings. Get involved in a community like yours, and getting involved in the community, asking questions, finding out those added values, the value stack items that you can help or learn from, and then go out and offer it, There's so many resources now on YouTube and these communities that we're involved in. You can ask the question. 100 people have seen that problem. So you're not alone. A lot of times people won't start because I don't know all the what's going to happen. I don't understand every aspect of it. Well, if you have a good community, you can just ask and have the answer like that, and then you can help whoever your client is. So just start. Just start. Get the first one. Even if you have to do it for free, that would be my advice.
I love that. Well, Eric, thank you so much for being here, man. I appreciate it. And I continue to look forward to seeing you absolutely crush it, man.
Absolutely. Thank you so much.
So guys, thank you so much for watching the video. I really appreciate it. If you have any questions, drop them right down below in the comments. If you are interested, okay, in getting more like Eric and trying to actually do better with your agency, I have a video that's going to pop up on the screen. It's going to be about my free partnership. It is the same thing as if you go down below and sign up with my 30-day free trial link down below. If you sign up with High Level under me, you're going to get over $10,000 worth of free bonuses. That's live coaching calls, like 4 per week, access to trainings on how to sell high level, trainings on how to master high level, snapshots, AI prompts, done for you prospecting systems, and so much more. And again, it's all free if you're using High Level under me. So what I recommend you do is you go down below, you click that link, you check it out, or you watch the video that pops up at the end of the screen because it's going to go over all of this. So guys, thanks again. Questions, drop them down below, and make sure you watch the video that pops up at the end of the screen.